Hello everyone, we're back. I'm back from a 2 week break. Last week I was at Retro Revival event in Walsall. And while I was there, I bought some stuff. One of the things I bought was this. This is the Namco NegCon. Is it NegCon? NegCon controller. It's an analogue controller for the PlayStation 1. It was released in 1995-ish, or maybe 96, not sure. But anyway, it's an analog controller before the DualShock controllers arrived, so because the DualShocks were in a lab somewhere, no one knew what was going on with PlayStation, so Namco came along and, although ostensibly a software company, did the hardware stuff as well. And one of the things they did an arcade stick for the PS1, which is fantastic, but they also did this. Now, this thing's a very strange controller. I've got to leave my elbow over the mic here. But as you can see, it's got two halves to it. And you've got the D-pad there, and you've got four buttons here. First interesting thing, apart from this thing in the middle here, is this these two buttons here. These are analog buttons. These are sensitive, pressure-sensitive buttons. They've got about 7 millimeter travel on them. It's quite a long way. So they actually are pressure sensitive. So long before the PlayStation 2 and indeed PlayStation 3 go out for those pressure sensitive buttons, they had them on this. And these two shoulder buttons similarly are analog as well. But the real trick with this controller is it actually twists. Do you see? Twists like this. So that's how you sort of steer the car. That's how it was invented to primarily for driving games. It's for steering driving games, because playing Ridge Racer with the D-pad on the PlayStation was odd, and Namco knew it was odd, so they decided to make this controller. Something else, other aspects, you see this sort of divot, sort of recess in the controller there. That's actually yes, you rest your thumb over it just like that, and you sort of have one, the back part of your thumb accelerating, the front going on to brake. Although no one brakes in Ridge Racer games, which was what we're playing tonight. Yes, we're playing Ridge Racer, Rage Racer, the third Ridge Racer game. I have a copy here. It's PAL, I'm afraid. I know. But yeah, it's a PAL version, and yes, it's my actual copy. Look, there it is. Had it all these years. Haven't played it that much. But Rage Racer. Pretty, there it is. And it was double PAL format, double disc format thing. Anyway, it's got a demo disc in it, I found. It's kind of fun. So, what we're going to do is we're just going to start. So, we're going to do a Grand Prix. Let's just go. Right, let's just do Grand Prix. I'll do a new one because I've actually got some saves on the memory card for this PlayStation 1 I'm running it on. So, yeah. So, no one knows where the Rage began or how this drivers became known as Rage Racers. Who knows? Do you really want to see this crawl or do you want to see the game? Let's see the game. Let's see the game. Right, so it's the first car, and car select, class. So let's go car select. So this is the car, and you can customize it a bit. So I'm going to customize it because it looks a bit bland. You can go for tires, by the way. At the moment, it's defaulted on drift. If you notice, just there, so you can actually reduce it and make it so it's more grippy, or put it on drift. I think I'm going to put it there. So there's that. Transmission levers, auto. Design, you can do some amazing things. You can do team logo, you do team name. Well, I'll show you, look, team logo. You can do all sorts of stuff. It's blank at the moment, but I can get a sample. No, let's not do that. Paint. Or you can actually just draw anything you like. It's a team logo, which is kind of cool. That's not it. So let's exit out of that. But I'm not going to do that. So just do the paint colour, because I don't like the colour. So I'm going to go A here, and let's put the main paint colour there, the body colour, yellow. There's a reason for that. there's a historical reference to me. Planetside. Played Planetside for years, and that's the colours of the NC. So whenever I play any other game I can change colours, I always do NC colours. Sorry, it's just what we did. NC all the way. So, okay, that's the car. And just go. See how this goes. So, done a bit of practicing today. I'm not great. I'm not gonna lie to you. But still having fun with it. So one thing about sort of starting is you gotta. Here you go. So yeah, so you just sort of twist it, and it goes left and right. That's it. I'll do more of that later, but that's basically it. So it's a classic Ridge Racer, really, but I think it's got a lot more cars and tracks and things. Now, concentration phase on. So now I chew my tongue when I'm concentrating. It's a thing that I do. No! Disaster! Did you see that? Of course you did. You're watching as well. Am I supposed to be angry? Hello, devil. No. You got a good point there. Should I be angry while playing Rage Racer? I don't know. I'm not particularly angry. Sunday afternoon and all that, but... Anyway, got past the blue car. One thing annoys me about Ridge Racer games, they start you at the back. What is that about? Anyway, yeah, I'm liking the analogue control, which you kind of used to on stuff like the PlayStation 2 and etc. And PlayStation 3 onwards, or PlayStation... The latter part of the PlayStation era and that kind of thing. But I don't think these early Ridge Racer games actually supported analogue sticks. I might be wrong though, answers on a postcard. I'm fine, thanks, Devil. Difficult to read chat while playing this game, I've got to say. One thing, I mean, as much as I love playing PlayStation games, some of the texture warping does get to me. Bit of a heretical thing to say, I know, but it's just... One thing strikes me about specifically Rage Racer and Ridge Racer games is that the sound doesn't match the visuals. The sound quality is way better. It's incredible. I mean, the directional sound as I'm going through the tunnel and stuff, it's just... I mean, with the headphones, it's even better, but it's just incredible. I'm not doing terribly well here because I'm not focusing on the race. But yeah, really, really impressed. Even though this game came out in 1996, that's 23 years ago. I'm on 4, I need... That's not good, that wasn't keeping my cool. Anyway, yes. So I'm not going to do Terry well because I'm still getting to grips with this controller, which is still, you know, it's a fascinating thing. You just sort of twist it. And it's very intuitive once you get used to it. That makes no sense. It is very intuitive. It genuinely is. You're basically just sort of rocking your arms left and right. It's great. There is some calibration required, so... There's a lot of grip to this car. I think I've messed up with the tyres. I need to get at least third to get to the next round. Wish me luck, everyone. Got to pass this car. No! There you go. Now I've got him. He's in my rear view mirror. Last corner. No! Oh, I'm good. Whew! Anyway, back to chat. A little heresy, never. Anyway, in chat, we've got Devil. I say there's a lot of detail in the ad banners. You're right, there is a lot of detail in the ad banners. So, yeah. Anyway, that was fun. Now, one of my favourite games on the PSP is actually Ridge Racer. Ridge Racer 1 and 2 on the PSP. Fantastic versions of those games. It's like holding a portable version of a PlayStation 2. Really, really good. I got so addicted. I really did really, really well. Never finished it, though. I never got to the special bit where you actually get a Pac-Man car, which is amazing. I never got to that stage. But I've always liked the Ridge Racer games. I'm not sure if there are really racing games in the traditional sense. They are pure arcade racing games. But yeah, now we can see the PlayStation here showing off its thing, doing a bit of replay there. And I got third. I wasn't really focusing because I was talking too much. But yeah. Anyway, I got through to third. I can do better though. I can do better. I got some money. Some credit, so I can use that to buy things, I assume. If you're curious, I am not emulating this at all. I'm running it on my PlayStation 1, the PS1, and the little miniature versions. Not the regular sort of larger grey one, so the one they released later on in its life. It's also got the LCD screen on it, which I'm not actually using, because I'm using it on a larger screen. But yeah, so this is a new track. I like this track, actually. There's some really good corners, sort of, yeah. Car shop. So I thought I'd pop along here to see if I can buy anything. Clearly I can't, I've only got 80 EG, whatever EG is. But anyway, let's go back. Engineer shop, if I can buy anything in engineer. No, tune up. Oh, I don't have enough money. It's all my life. Right, okay. So just start then. So yeah, it's kind of cool. It's really intuitive doing this. But you can go out of calibration. You have to go into options to just like any analog stick. So one of the things that saddens me about Ridge Racer is that, you know, Namco kind of abandoned it. My favourite Ridge Racer was Ridge Racer, well, one of my favourites, sorry, not my favourite, but one of my favourites is, come on, you can do better, Chris, you can do better, there you go. No, is Ridge Racer 7 on the PlayStation 3. But that game is 12 years old. I believe it's 12 years old, might be wrong. Yeah, 2007? Yeah. Ridge Racer 7, one of my favourites, but 12 years old. I'm not focusing. And I really wish they'll go back to it. I mean, they never released Ridge Racer on PlayStation 4. What's that about? You know, it's a staple of the PlayStation, but they never... I don't remember. No! It's meant to be a smooth corner, and it's really messed up. Yeah, I'm really... I saw him in a back view and I thought I had to cut him off. I can do better. No, this thing really, really works. I'm happy I bought it. It was only £18. from a store, the name of which is escaping me. I need to find out. Try and remember. I've got to remember what the name of the store is. I did promise I'll tell it. I'll stream when I stream the game. And I'm showing off. It's yeah. Damn it. Retro Game Extreme, I think it is, something like that. Oh, sorry. I'll put a link in the YouTube archive. There you go. Oh, smooth. Smooth moves. Now I'm getting into it. Now I'm getting into it. So, the thing about these earlier Ridge Racers, they've got no boost. No boost. What's that about? Why no boost? You just have to just race. There's no draft either. There's no slipstreaming, I should say. Nothing. Just got to drive. Whereas the later games, they had boost and slipstreaming and all, and you know, in order to get boost, you had to drift and all sorts. But no. I'm not doing as well as I should. Yeah, try to cut, overtake him on the inside, and that failed. I got third place. I'd like to do better than just scrape through on third place, though. I'm better than this on Ridge Racer games, really. I didn't attack that corner right at all. Did that better, though. You know what, I might see the second place player. Or car. Right, there he is! Well, she. Just to be clear, could be a man or woman driving that. I do not know. And I'm in second. Last corner. There's first place. Am I going to grab it? Am I going to grab it? Am I just going to get a little bit too excited? Yeah, I got too excited! No! Got second, apparently. Oh, he wasn't first. He wasn't first. Is this Santorini? I'm not sure. Could be. We'll have to check what the name is. That game is almost as old enough to play as a T-rated game. Yeah. Yeah, it is. I do find it funny when you play games that are so old that they can actually drink. I think I was lapping. That car wasn't in first place. I was about to lap the last place. That's what that was. That happened a lot in Ridge Racer on the PlayStation. Got second. I can do better. I know. I can do better. However, more monies. Which is nice. Yeah, I mean, Ridge Racer. I've talked to a lot of other members of the Kane and Rince crew about this on our Slack channel, and they all said this was their favourite. It's not my personal favourite, I haven't played it enough. Like I said, mine is Ridge Racer 6 or 7. 6 is really good on the 360. I remember buying that on import, it's great. Devil's saying that, he has got a full name, by the way. It's. I'm going to read it out to you. I think Devil and the Vexilla Regis. I'm sure what that means. But anyway, he's saying that the game came out when I was probably stuffing coins in my mouth. Right. Not the case for myself. This game came out. Okay, I'm going to say it delicately. This game came out when I graduated from university. So, all those years ago. Right, let's go. We can do this. I believe in me. I can do the thing. So this is all Mythical Coast. All this stuff. Yes, for foolish me, I went to university all those years ago. So, I'll try to do the boost start. I'm not sure if boost start exists in this game. Because it exists in 6 and 7, so I'm hoping it does in Rage. Anyway, there's a turn off here. This turn off is really... It's a tricky... It's a nasty one, that. It's like a turn into the hill. Yeah. One thing I like about Ridge Race is it takes a basic same sort of track and then you just sort of raced. I almost jumped over him. I like jumping over cars, it's great. I did that well. I attacked that really well. I was happy with myself on that. The directional sound in this game is great. Ah, poopy. I am liking this controller. If you can get hold of one, like I said, it wasn't that expensive. I think £18 for one of these is a pretty good deal. I have seen one box, but they go for about £45. If they're box, maybe even more. It's a bit excessive for controller. But yeah, very good. No! Precious seconds. Precious seconds. No! Right, there we go. Got some more targets in my headlights. Can slip by both of them. Yeah, that wasn't as slick as last time. Never mind. So I've seen people try to play like shoot 'em ups with this controller, which strikes me as a little bit silly. Not a good idea. Why would you want to do that? I mean, if one game that needs a digital input is a shoot 'em up. So why would you use an analogue controller for a shoot 'em up? I don't know. Answers on a postcard. Take 'em now. No! I had to stop him. I had to stop him getting by. It was a horrible move, I know, but... There you go. Concentration face on. I'm aiming to get first. I can do this. That's not the first player. Because I don't think it is. I might be lapping. No! Do not believe that's the first player. Might be wrong. No! I think he might be actually, on reflection. Yeah, it is! The yellow car is the first player. Just overtake the blue car here. Someone catch him again. I made some errors, I'll grant you that. No, I'm not going to get him. No! So I'm getting excited. Losing concentration. Yeah, lost him. Sorry I let you down, everyone. Never mind. Next race. Next race. Next Mythical Coast, your ancient Greek columns are the name that makes sense. That's true. Yeah. The Sweden chat, everyone. Sorry. Maybe some people are just more used to analogue. Yeah, I'm certainly more used to analogue, especially nowadays. Can't handle digital input anymore. No, I can't either. You can try this one again if you want. I could. But I want to see more tracks. I want to see more content, right? I mean, I'll be fine. $400. There you go. Now loading. So $400. Let's just go. Go. Can't afford anything. Still got no money. I should have changed the music. Sorry about that. Yeah, so in Ridge Racer 6 and 7, if you don't go into the red zone when you do the acceleration, it boosts like a super boost. It's a bit like, you know, Mario Kart, where you sort of go start. I don't think it's doing it in this, though. Oh, that wasn't very clever. Still straight ahead. No! I took that too tight this time. Oh well. I'm going to get that corner. I will manage. I will master that corner. I will do it. But today is not that day. Well, this particular lap is not that lap. I remember in Ridge Racer 6, there were like alternate routes for the same track. It's good game. But yeah, it's 2006 that came out. It's 13 years ago. Still a good game. Doesn't stop it from being a good game. Like this one. But yeah. Damn it. I can do this. No. Took it too late. The thing about Ridge Racer is you shouldn't ever slow down. You shouldn't have to. Or Rage Racer, or any Ridge Racer game. I should say it's Rage Racer. No. If I'm taking corners like that, can't master that corner. I will get it, though. I will figure it out. But yeah, I'm liking the controller. I'm happy I own it. It does make this game might more pleasant to play on a PlayStation 1. Whoa! That wasn't fair! Have I played any of the Resistance series? Yes, I have. First one wasn't bad. Strange game. Set in just after World War II. Where aliens have invaded. But they don't want... None of the government wants to admit it. But it's basically a full-scale alien invasion. It's kind of cool. From what I remember. But it came out at the same time as Killzone. As an FPS. But I could stream it one day, but it's the sort of game I normally stream. That was not fair. I thought I did that corner really well. Here's my nemesis. Not the car in front, by the way, this corner. Did a little bit better that time, but not as smooth as I want it to be. There you go. Like an absolute mess of this. Oh, he got it from me. There's a board saying, Devil Car, look at that corner. Okay. So I'm just going to read a little bit more chat. Thanks, Devil. This chat's great. Not racing game, but have you played in Resistance series? I said, yes, I have. In my opinion, the first one is a hidden gem. Interesting. It's been a while since I played it, so yeah, should give it a shot. Yeah, cool. Got third. I'm not sure how I'm going to progress at all. But yeah. Here we go. Let us continue if it allows me to. How many tracks are there for? I don't know. Anyway, let's just keep going. Okay, let's go. Same car. How much money have I got? No, I don't think I've got enough money to buy anything. No, still haven't got... No. Let's go. Need more monies. Yeah, I'm a big fan of FPSs. Gonna have to say. Not gonna lie. Do like them. Especially the head story heavy ones, like Resistance, but you know, I never got into as much as I did Killzone, but after Killzone 3 I just lost interest. Because the one on PlayStation 4, the Killzone on PlayStation 4 was it was just absurd game, boring. Really, shouldn't have gone into his back. I saw him there. Anyway, I took that corner well, didn't I? Not that one though. I'm definitely getting better. One of the things I love about doing these streams is I play these games and I get demonstrably better. Although this corner is still, I still can't do that corner. I will figure it out eventually. I think I'm having to redo this track over and over because I need to get silver in order to progress. I think that's what's going on. It's not being very communicative to me, game. Because I didn't remember. I think I read. Oh well. In that case, I'll focus a lot more than I have been. I was picking up some speed there. Damn. That happens a lot. I focus on cars, but not actually what's going on ahead. Very annoying. Anyway, trick to driving games is don't think about where you are. Think about where you're going. In other words, look at the horizon. Always look at the horizon. Can't get past this car. That corner. Honestly, that corner. New car. There we are. There we are. Car. Yeah, I can see him. I can see him. Right. Let's go for one. Let's go for gold. Enough of this silver nonsense. Just gotta focus. There's orange. There he is. Or her. Sorry. Them. There they are. There you go. That's better. Right. Turn too late. I can do this. No. Damn it, I knew I was going to hit him. Nah, sorry everyone, I let everyone down. Me included. Never mind. Never mind. This series is all about drift. Use your brake to slide through corners. You're right, Devil. However, the tyres on this particular car I set have got strong grip. So there's not a lot of drifting going on. I could change it, but, you know. You said in the philosophy of the series, never slow down, but you might need to rethink that when you're drifting corners. Yeah, you're right. But like I said, the tyres on this are a bit... You know, there's different types of ridge racing cars. And this one, I've actually made it so the grip's quite strong. For good or ill. For good or ill. But anyway. Yes, the grip is messing. When I say messing, it's deliberately sticking me to the track, which means I can't really drift. Which is fine. I mean, I'm a rod from my own back. Let's go to this one. I think if I change the tyres, which I won't do now, I'll just race this track now. Because I've just changed track. So at that point, if I had... Because I did let go of the accelerator there to get around that corner. As I just did then. Just to demonstrate something. I didn't even bother. I could have just, but the car, there's a lot of grip on these tyres. Which is my own fault. So I've got a different track here. Nice and different. No! Can't get past this car. It's not playing fair. Not very sportsmanlike. There you go. liking this track. There's lots more going on. Even though I'm not doing terribly well at it. I'm not familiar with it. It's good though. So, look, underpasses, overpasses, tunnels. No. Just not feeling it though. Well, let's continue. Persevere. I shattered a record, apparently. Alright, let's see if I can... 2 laps to go! It's really satisfying when you get around corners reasonably well. It's one thing about the Ridge Racer games, even though this is Rage Racer, of course. Keep on hitting that outcropping. Fourth. If we get past this fellow, I'll be third. There we are. Second! Yes! I won't get first though. Couldn't get first on the earlier track, so I definitely can't get first on this one. You never know, might manage it. Just not judging the cornering at all. He's gonna overtake me, no, is he? No, I'm good. I'm good. Okay, final lap. See, this is what happens when you have gripping tires. Ah! I'm going to have to change the tires so I can do some drifting, because these tires on this car are not allowing it to happen. Now I'm back in third. I think I'll grab it from him, but I'm not going to get first, which is sad. But never mind. Can't have everything. No. Honestly, the directional sound in this game is incredible. Especially considering how old it is. It's just... I just see the first player up ahead. Or the first car. But, yeah. Not gonna catch them. There he is. I did it! by a fraction of a second. Oh, well. The real measure of a race is how well they can adapt. Yes. This is true. Maybe I have adapted to this to these high gripping tyres. It's always the yellow ones that are ripping ahead. Not this time, it was the white one. And yes, thank you. I was successful. This makes me feel good. Which is, I suppose, the aim of the game. So first, look at all that money! Wow, the amount of money you get for getting first is astonishing. Look at that. Yes, lots. Thank you. Do the next one. No point doing the last one. This is great. Now, I'll show you what I mean by the tyres. Right? Show you what I mean. Tyre. See? It's halfway between grip. So if I shove it over here, it's now more in a drift mode. So just do that. So let's see what happens. Let's see what happens. Almost went into the back of him. Or her. Them. It's all far too confusing. You know, I really was very sceptical about this controller. I am no longer sceptical. They're excellent. They are, yeah, Rage Racer and this controller, it's a marriage made in heaven. It's great. Oh, what's different? I'm going off to the left. No! Can't get past them. The road is too narrow. The blimp! Wow, this track is really narrow. Straight into the side of the bridge parapet. Well done. In another car racing game, this car would have exploded, but no, not Rage Racer. Oh no. You're this big invincible box of invincibleness. This is not Gran Turismo. Here we go. Four. There's car number three. Not what I had in mind. Always the way I get too excited when I get too close to them and then slam into the side of them. Like then. Now the road's really narrow. There you go. Not good. Not good. Oh, I took that corner better this time. I was smashed into the side of the bridge. Not a lot of drifting going on. One thing I haven't done, I've noticed, is I've been driving in completely the sort of driver view, because I prefer to actually get a better sense of speed. However, maybe next race, the last race I'm going to do, which because we're getting close to finishing the stream, we've only streamed for an hour. It's the last race I'll do it in third person, like behind the car view. Just to see how I'll do. I normally do worse that mode, but let's just have a look what it looks like. I like the encouragement the commentator gives. That was a bit cheeky of me. I bounced off them, but never mind. Oh, driving like a drunk person. Come on. No. I really don't deserve second at this rate. If I get taken over, I deserve it. This is terrible. Come on. Yeah, they are. So I'm talking to the commentator. She tells me that they're on to me. She's very true. Yeah. Second it is. Second it is. Hands a bit stiff. There it is. Next time, first place is mine. Yeah, if I actually just, you know, focus on what I'm supposed to be doing. Can I buy anything with that money? I think it's 1600, wasn't it? The minimum. Class up bonus! Class up bonus, everyone! I've cleared Calm GP, get on to the next class! See, I may have been driving like a drunk person, but it doesn't matter. This is class two. Car shop. Oh, can't afford that. Sad face. Engineer shop. Let's spruce this one up. Let's tune it up. Yes! So now it's slightly better. Hooray! Right. All right. Well, I did say I'll do a third-person view, so let's do that. Let's do third-person view and see what it looks like. You'd probably take a frame rate hit. Normally happens. No, I'm not used to this at all. This is horrible. Oh, do I have to do this? No, fine. I'll do it. I'll do it. Speaking of drunk people, oh, this is horrible. Fine. I have no sense of steering. It's just so strange. I barely see anything. Oh well. Thank for that nudge. Oh. Oh, this is horrible. Carry on. I'm going to persevere. Not going to give up. Anyway. I think the car's going slightly faster. I might be wrong. I did spend 1,600 credits on it to make it go faster. Oh. Yeah, it's not a view I prefer to drive in, as you can see. Oh. Who drives Ridge Racer like this? It's horrible. Just can't see anything. It's got this great lump in the middle of the screen. I might just return. Oh god. Yeah. I've just noticed there's a time limit. You see it in the bottom left-hand corner. It's a time limit. Apparently, I've got to do this in 6 minutes. Or 6 minutes, 50 seconds. I'm not sure if I'm going to manage it. Badly. Oh, God. This is terrible. Yeah, I can't drive like this. I'll carry on. I'm not going to change the view. I'm going to be stubborn. Yeah, it just doesn't feel right at all. Okay. See if I can get better than that last lap. See if I can just take over a few more cars. Not at this rate, though. Devil's saying, this is not going well. No, it's not! I don't like driving third-person view on driving games, unless it's a rally game. Rally game, all about the third-person view. Oh yeah. But when it comes to like tarmac races like this one, like Ridge Racer or Forza, no way. No way. Can't deal with it. Oh. Let's just put this out of the misery. Take it outside and shoot it. Oh, stop it. Yeah, that was abysmal. Okay. So we'll just end the race, I think. Oh, look, chance four gone. I lost the chance. But yeah, I think we'll just end it there. Thanks very much for watching. I had a really good time playing Rage Racer. Excellent game with the NegCon controller. If you can get hold of one, I highly recommend it for these games. It's just, provided you play it on first person view or the cockpit view or driver view, not third person, that's awful. But yeah, again, thanks for watching. We'll be back next week with Turrican 2 on the Amiga. I decided to play a bit of Turrican on my Amiga 1200, A1200. So do pop along for that. In the meantime, thanks for watching. We'll see you again next week. Bye.